The recovery that began in 2009 has faltered, and the global economic outlook has deteriorated significantly in recent months. The United States is slowing. In Japan, reconstruction has boosted growth, but there too the pace is slackening. The euro area appears to be heading into a downturn. Emerging economies are still growing at a healthy pace, but even their growth rates are moderating. Confidence is dropping sharply, trade growth is weakening, and the forecast looking ahead is worrisome.
Our central forecast for the next 2 years looks like a muddling through situation, with the US recovering growth only slowly, the euro area entering into mild recession, and Japan growing faster because of the reconstruction, but then with growth fading away.
Extremely high and persistent unemployment remains one of the most visible impacts of the global economic crisis. The United States and the euro area are both experiencing near record levels of joblessness, while Japan's unemployment rate is also well above norms.
Unemployment remains stubbornly high. We can count as many as 45 million people unemployed in the OECD area, many of which are young people. To revert this terrible trend, we must boost growth quickly and we must use much more effectively public money, especially by targeting labor market policies.
The OECD presents two alternative scenarios around its central forecast looking forward. In the downside scenario, excessive spending cuts in the United States and intensification of the euro area debt crisis impact in all major regions, cutting as much as 2 percentage points from growth in the US, the Eurozone, and Japan in 2012, and even more in 2013. China is also hit. A successful resolution of the euro area debt crisis, on the other hand, could lead to an upside scenario, under which growth in the United States, the euro area, and Japan is higher than expected. China also benefits under this hypothesis. More than is usually the case, world economic prospects now depend on the highly uncertain nature and timing of government action.
If there is a sovereign debt default in the euro area and contagion spreads, and if there is no effective policy response, both at the country level and at the European level, we might have a very serious downside scenario with prolonged recession and rising unemployment. If, however, policy response is effective, broad and sustained, we might turn the downside scenario into an upside scenario in Europe and elsewhere, where growth becomes strong, confidence is restored, and unemployment starts falling.